The last talk of this session is by Dr. Alberto Canelas from the University of Coimbra, Portugal.
So I would like to thank the organizers for the opportunity for this presentation. And just to, for context, I'm talking a little bit about our recent interests, which include inclusion complexes. They are a very interesting system with vast experimental, it was the proximity. So inclusion complexes are very interesting objects with a vast experimental data. And for the theoretician, they are vastly inexplored. Even the basic theories like the flexible molecule approximation are still being debated and tested. Some of the inclusion complexes now include different hosts, like the bamboozurils and the cucurbiturils, with some added interest to this type of approach. Our group also has a lot of interest in drug delivery, essentially transdermal, also buccal, intestinal, and targeting to the brain. So we also have an experimental component. But our main interest is clearly polyelectrolytes and polyelectrolytes interactions. We now have some ventures in collaboration with Barcelona, Ramon Itrija, in which they modify DNA and RNA, which is a magnificent work. And it's very nice to collaborate in these new systems, including origami DNAs and similar systems. But what we do more regularly is to build models and to make simulations with experiments with different aspects, translocation of polyelectrolytes, compaction, confinement, etc. Very recently with Marie, here present, we addressed confinement. This is a rerun of some previous work. But confinement is not limited to space. We also have confinement, for instance, in adsorption. This was a very simple system. Adsorption, it was a finite, regularly charged surface. And then we tried to adsorb a single chain. And we had these interesting patterns that were dependent on the size of the chain. If the chain was longer, it would adsorb in the ends. If the chain was short, it would adsorb in the center. And things became even more interesting when we tried to look at several chains adsorbed at the same surfaces. We even obtained these rayon triangles, you know, that are used in drills to excavate squares. And it's what happens here. We have a square, but the square is composed of the superimposition of several triangles. Coming closer to the topic that I'm going to talk about, some years ago, with Bjorn, Maria, Perlins and Rita, we addressed the problem of adsorption onto mobile, on a surface composed of mobile charges. And we learned a lot. In fact, this was a system that was essentially governed by correlation. And so if we would freeze the surface, adsorption would decrease. If we rigidify the polyelectrolyte, adsorption would decrease. And it was for mobile charges with more flexible polyelectrolytes that we would attain a maximum of adsorption. Adsorption was even capable. We had adsorption of like-charged surface and polyelectrolyte up to a point. The model used is very simple. So this is a spring and ball model, and we have mobile charges. We have added now in this work also some crowders not charged, and we have negative and positive charges, and we have the polyelectrolyte. So very, very simple model. What happens? It happens that in the regions where the polyelectrolyte touches, it minimizes the presence of the negative charges. This is a polyanion, minimizes the presence of negative charges, and it recalls the positive charges, which is what we see here. This is the bulk or the unperturbed surface. This is the distribution we find when the polyelectrolyte comes in touch with the surface. For doing this, we divided the surface in several squares and we measure how many particles we have in each square. What we see here is that mainly the degree of adsorption is commanded by the interaction with the surface. But you can see something else, is that for the same interaction energy, there are several degrees of adsorption. So this is not a one-to-one correspondence exactly. We also looked at what I called mixture, which is to see if we have positive and negative charges, and if we have a negative polyelectrolyte, it calls the positive charges, but how do the negative charges interfere with its interaction? And we see that this is not clearly monotonic, but in fact, in these results, the effect of mixing is not that visible. I'll show you something different in another slide. Now, we put crowders. Crowders, they move in the surface, they are not charged. And what do they do exactly? Essentially, they exclude volume. So the charged particles are switched into some patches. And what we can see in these RDFs is that the proximity of the charged particle increases. And what can we see here? We can see that something else happens, is that the asymmetry in the occupation of the surface also increases, because if we have crowders, we expel the charged particles, which means that in some of the parts we don't have particles, in some we have an excess, so the distribution enlarges. At the same time, and you can see it here, what happens is that the overall charges shrinks. We have more charges, and positive charges and negative charges are closer. So the effect is that for the same squares, we have less charge if we have the crowders. Okay. What about conformation? What happens when the polyelectrolyte adsorbs? Because this is an important question, because I remember that one of the more obvious experimental systems for this type of thing is cationic vesicles, and it was work by Bjorn, Maria, and Rita on cationic vesicles that motivated our first attempt at this system. And what was seen experimentally was that there was some degree of compaction. That is, when the polyelectrolyte approaches the cationic vesicle, there was a certain degree of compaction, probably because you would also concentrate the charges. And so in here, we see, of course, our chain is very small, but we see a slight decrease. We see also an increase in the component on the surface, of course, because the thing is being flattened upon the surface. Here, we see another different thing. This is a characterization in which we have trains. Trains are, let's say, monomers that are adsorbed consequently, in sequence. And what we see is that for the same adsorption, we have different patterns of adsorption. In some cases, we have more trains. In some cases, we have less trains. This is probably the explanation for the fact that adsorption on its own does not govern, interaction on its own does not govern adsorption, because we have different patterns for adsorption. And this is clearly seen here. Up to now, we have been looking at the system in terms of observables, that is, things that we can measure in the simulation. We are now trying to have some functional form, not a very pretentious one, but just a descriptive function for what we have seen. Of course, to have a descriptive function, we must translate into characteristics of the system and not observables. We want to have some characteristics. Of course, for the time being, the characteristics are limited to the surface. We have not made changes in salt. We have not introduced rigidity of the chain. We have not yet introduced linear charge density. So the characteristics are characteristics of the surface so far. First, we see that adsorption increases fast in the beginning and then slows down. This suggests an hyperbolic tangent as a function of the charge in the surface. Let me say something. I forgot, and this is probably the most important result. We can have adsorption, very different degrees of adsorption, to the same, exactly the same surface charge density. So if you vary the characteristics of the surface and maintain the same charge density, you also vary the degree of adsorption. So this part is very easily described by an hyperbolic tangent. But then we have a problem. If we make the representation in terms of the density of positive charges, we see that it decreases from one side and from the other. So we have a maximum. For this side, we have too little charges to adsorb. They are the same. They warrant the same charge density. But in fact, it's impossible to polarize on this side. So we have used the Weibull-like function. You know, Weibull is that change in first order into, it's very common in the release profiles of drugs. So this describes this decrease. But we have also the decrease to the other side. This decrease comes from the presence of more and more negative charges. Of course, this presence causes some effect, but effect is diminished if the overall charge density is important. Then we introduce crowders. From this to here, there is a crowder. So the crowders also decrease adsorption. So we are almost at the end. We have this, we are on this side. We have this, and we have the reduction caused by the number of negative and by the number of neutral charges. So the overall result is this one. And of course, least squares does not validate this thing, but it's very nice to look at what we can get. And here I made some more detailed representation of what we see in terms of adsorption and dependence on the number of positive chains. So what we see here, we see that we can have a lot of variations in terms of adsorption for almost similar charges, apparently. We see that correlation is really important in this type of thing. And we see that essentially crowding agents tend to reduce the degree of adsorption. Thank you very much.
Questions? Yep.
This reminds me very much a biologically interesting example, and this is the adsorption of a protein called MARX, which is an intrinsically disordered protein, basic protein, flexible, when it absorbs on a membrane, on a mixed membrane, and this also experimentally verified, containing monovalent and trivalent or tetravalent anionic lipids. They are all mobile. And you see that the adsorption depends, of course, on the mobility. More than that, they sequester the polyvalent cations. This, by the way, has to do with counter-ion, counter-lipid release. The monovalent ones go away. And the polymer, the protein, sequester the polyvalent ones. And it's very similar to what you're saying.
And, thank you.
This work was published both experimentally and theoretically.
Yeah, I don't know if what I'm going to say makes sense, but just in case. When I look at just normal ion, you know, they're the Hofmeister series, and there's also a strong role of the polarizability of the ion. Would there be an equivalent of such an effect with PA, depending on the nature of the atoms making the PA, and how would you relate to that?
You have correlation here, but it's a correlation without some direct effect upon the ions. I mean, what you have, it's an overall correlation between the charges in the polymer and the charges in the surface. I wouldn't say that there is a direct, because you don't change the charges.
Okay, there are no more questions. So let's thank the speaker again and all speakers.